Hi guys, so now let's solve these questions based on loops. Okay, so starting with question number one. When int c is equal to 5, number variable is equal to 10, do num divide is equal to c, while c minus minus is the print of the value of number variable. Okay, when you solve this question guys, I'm sure that 99% of you guys would not give me the correct answer because you will directly jump into the conclusion. But stay focused, then now solve and then give me what is the answer. Now let's see how we can solve this. So what is num divide is equal to c is nothing, but it means num is equal, number is equal to number divided by c. Okay. So now c is 5 and this variable is 10. So this is what? 10 divided by value c is 5. So it is 2, right? So value of this number is 2. Now while c minus minus, so value c is right now 5 only. I am putting a 5 star because jab bhi dobara kahin pe c aayega value kitni ho jayegi 4, par abhi yahan pe kitni hai 5 hi hai, dobara loop chale, theek hai. To first time jo meri value aayi, main yahan pe move kar leta hu. First case mein jo meri value aayi, to num ki value meri aayi thi yahan pe 2, aur jab c mera kitna tha 5 tha, right? To ye loop dobara chale, to meri c ki value kitni ho chuki hai, मेरी c की वैल्यू हो चुकी है 4 और मेरे num की वैल्यू कितनी है 2, राइट? तो लूप चली, दिस इज व्हाट, नंबर इज इक्वल टू नंबर डिवाइड बाय c, द वैल्यू नंबर इज 2, सो 2 डिवाइड बाय c, द वैल्यू c इज नाउ बिकॉज़ ऑफ 5 माइनस 1 इज 4 एंड 2 बाय 4 इज 0, राइट? तो सेकंड टाइम द वैल्यू ऑफ नंबर इज 0 एंड व्हेन द वैल्यू ऑफ c इज 4, right? Now again you run a loop. Now the value of c is what? The value of c is 3 now, and the value of num is 0. So you will do what? 0 divided by 3, so it will be 0, right? So again the value of c will become what? 2. So again 0 divided by 2 is what? 0. Again you run a loop, the value of c is what? 1. So 0 divided by 1 is what? 0. Now see guys, so the value of c is 1, but when we run a loop again, then the value of c will become what? 0. Now when the value of c will become 0, so it is now 0 divided by 0. And when you divide a number by 0, it's a divide by 0 exception. It's a runtime error. Because the value of c at one time will become 0, and when you divide any number by 0, it's a runtime error. Runtime error. So your code won't compile. It will compile, but after like printing 1-2 values, it will give you a runtime error. And why this runtime error has occurred? Because the value of c has become 0 and you are dividing this 0 by 0, but you cannot divide a number by 0. It's a runtime exception. So for num is equal to 2, when number is 2 and c is 5, number is 0 when c is 4, number is 0 when c is 3, 0 when 2, 0 when 1, and when you divide 0 by 0, there comes your runtime error, right? So this is a pretty good question. And because we normally do not solve this, what we will do? We will simply write, if our logics are, we will simply write 2, 5, 0, 4, 0, 3, 0, 2, 0, 1, and 0, 0 we normally write. But we forget that we cannot divide number by 0. It will give you a runtime error. Fine. Now, moving on to the next question. Int n is equal to 9, 9 not equal to 0. It's pretty simple. Now 9 not equal to 0, your condition is 9 not equal to 0, condition is true. So when your condition is true, you come down and you print in n minus minus. So n is equal to 9 and putting a star here because it is post decrement. Jab dobara kahin pe n aayega, the value decrease hoga. The first value ka print hogi, n is equal to 9. So jab is n pe aayega, value kitni ho jayegi? 8, because it post decrement hai, 8. 8 minus minus hai. Ab jab dobara is 9 pe aayega, value kitni ho jayegi? 7. Next time it is 7 not equal to 0, condition true. So go down and it will print what? 7, n is equal to 7. Then go up, it is now n minus minus, so it will be 6, right? 6 minus minus, then you come here, it will be 5. Then again you go down, so it will print what? 5, n is equal to 5. So you can take this as a pattern 9, 7, 5. There's a difference of 2, 2. So next value it will print is 3. Then next value it will print is 1. Now then you see it is printing n is equal to 1. So this is the pattern. This is how it will print the value. Check then when the condition will become false, right? So 1 it is printing here. The value of n is what? 1. It is 1 minus minus, right? So for this the value of n is 0, right? When you come here, the value of n is minus 1, not equal to 0. Condition true. Again it is go down. So I think it's an infinite here. You can check how it is moving, right? So 9, then 7, then 5, then your 3, then your 2, then your 3, then your 9, 7, 5, 3, 1, then it is minus 1, right? So this is how. So it is an infinite loop. So good question. Just a slightly tricky question, but if your concepts are cool, then it is pretty simple. Now this is good question. Here int I is equal to 0. So you can have n number of printfs inside for loop. It's not an error. So this is my first expression. This is my second expression, and this is my third expression, and this is my fourth expression. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, as long as the condition is true. Fine. Now, first we will evaluate this. So printer 1, so 1 gets printed. Alright, this is pretty simple. Now in this, value of I is 0. So this is what? It's 0 less than 2 and your printf 2. So now what is happening? 0 less than 2, condition is true, so it will return what? 1, and it will print 2 first. So it will print 2 and it will then return number of character. How many character? 1 character. So 1 and 1 is 1, your condition is true, right? So your condition is true, then you go down and you print what? 4. The next value is 4. After this you go up. Now value of I is 0. So here the value of I becomes what? It is plus plus I. So when value of I is 0, then here the value of I is 1. So it is 1 and printf 3. So it will print this 3 and return what number of character, which is 1. So 1 and 1, your condition is true. But here no need to check the condition, right? So it will print because this condition is true, because here it is 1. So if it is 1, there is a logical operator, so we will check the second condition also. So far it will print 1, 2, 4, 3. Then again we will check the condition. Now because of plus plus I, the value of I has become 1 now. So it is 1 less than 2 and printf 2. So 1 less than 2, condition is true, it will return what? 1, and it will print what? 2, and return number of character, which is 1. So 1 and 1, condition is true. Again you go downstairs. Then again you print the value 4, right? Then again you move up, and what is the value of I? I is now plus plus I. The value of I is now 2. 2 and then printed 3, condition is true. So it will print what? 3. Again you check the condition. Now the value of I has become 2. So it is what? 2 less than 2. The condition becomes false. Now if condition is becoming false, it is 0. Now it is 2 less than 2 means 0. Your 0 condition is false. So if this is false, there is a logical AND. So we are not going to evaluate this. Because in case of logical AND, I told you so many times that if my first expression is false, I am not going to evaluate the second expression. So here the 2 remains unevaluated and you come out of the loop. So answer is 1, 2, 4, 3, 2, 4, 3. A pretty good question. So guys, you can see that in this slide, my playlist of loop, you will see the questions of very good standard. If you solve those questions, no need to go and look for various websites and all. You will get ample types of different types of questions based on loops. And these questions are very, very important. No matter what company you are sitting for placement, you won't get a question outside the concept. Right? Thank you so much. Take care.